where do the codes come from? Okay, you have to look at the objective of the process. We are looking to impact the way your body performs, specifically to identify those errors that create your symptoms. Because in this model, it is your body's misbehavior that allows symptoms to exist. So the codes, the objective of the codes is to identify the substances to which the body is misbehaving. So if I wanna, let's say you are exposed to ragweed, and as a result of ragweed, you sneeze and your eyes tear and all of that, and life is miserable. It is not the ragweed, it is your body's overreaction to the ragweed. There is where the area of error lies. So, in the early days, I would have people bring ragweed in a plastic bag for a focal point. Then I learned I could write the word ragweed down, and the body would focus on the ragweed just as if they were holding it. And of course, it uses numbers to break the ragweed down to different strains. So at the first time, I'll write the word ragweed, the misbehaviors in the organs, IO, the misbehavior of the cells, IC in the cells, and the numbers come in, how many strains of ragweed, and then you get your number from 1 to 300 strains of ragweed, except it's just R, 1 to 300. At first, I might write the ragweed right down for you, and then after that, it'll be R, 1 to 100, and the body knows that it's to define the strains to which it is overreacting. So that's where the codes come from. It's kind of like common sense that we need to focus on the area we're making mistakes, except that I'm always using the muscle test, the body, to affirm I've got the right code written so that it works for the body. When it comes to those letters like BTB, it'll generally go 1-BTB. What is that? Well, the body sometimes has to break things down to its molecular frequency. And there are billions and billions of different frequencies that may be radiated by any particular substance according to the body. So BTB would stand for billion, trillion, billion. I guess I could use infinity. The body will define how many different frequency variations there are, but this just gives a format for the body to include every part of the substance to which you are misbehaving. It's sort of like infinity. The body may use only 1 to 100. Another body might use 1 to a couple of 100,000. I just like to broaden the scope so that there's a tremendous amount of definition to a particular substance from a frequency per view, the body can accommodate it. So, and again, each code is approved by the body. So as hard it is for me to think that the body could break something down to a billion, trillion, billion variations of frequency at a molecular level, if the body approves it, then it's on your sheets and your body can use it. The music that people listen to in this process is a way to keep the body focused on the error. Pavlov's dogs prove that music can be associated with physical responses. If your body has been making an error, let's say it's been fighting ragweed like mine was for 40 years, you can't just mention that once and expect a full change in behavior. When we first started this process, people would have to take one page of these codes, like ragweed in the organs, ragweed in the cells, ragweed strain from 1 to 100,000, and they would have to read it for the full hour to get through to their body, because one mention maybe doesn't change 40 years of habit. What we found is we could substitute that very painful process of having to reread those codes with, after you read the codes, you put on the music and the body links into that and then essentially reviews it in its own way till all the information is absorbed and the changes are made. So that's the role of the music. It stops people from having to read these codes for an hour over and over and over again. When we first started, I would write one page of codes. I said, oh my gosh, I can write codes. And the brain will generate the frequencies of where the errors are occurring. And so the body would say, you can only do one set of codes. And I'd say, hey, is he going to read this for an hour? They would lay on that table and read that scribble for an hour. Reread that insane, yeah, for an hour. And they kept coming because it was working, you know. I was allergic to ragweed for, you know, 40 years, and it was hell. It wasn't just allergy. It was living hell. I used to sit there with red ants crawling through my sinuses and eyes, trying to think during ragweed season. And I go, I'm having such a hard time functioning here. And I would talk to someone who had total peace because their bodies weren't fighting the ragweed, and I'd get angry at them. How can you possibly sit there in ragweed season and not suffer like me and think in peace? So yeah, they would read those codes over and over again because relief is relief. And if you've had a nagging symptom for 10, 20, and 30 years, it's like heaven when it leaves.
Thank you for watching. If you found this video interesting, please click the thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified every time we release a new video.